I don't know which piece to have. Come on, move your hands. Ooh, that's a small ice. Today's pretty exciting. I've never been, but we're going to where's this place?
Where are
they? We're going to Villa Gazi Street. You know those restaurants where they sell like all the traditional food and whatever? So we're going there. My mom's entertaining some colleague friends, so they're from Barbados.
Do you want to talk?
You're already in the vlog, mom.
No, I don't want to talk. It's fine.
Oh my gosh. Hi, Kumo.
Hi.
So we're going to pick them up in the East End, and then after that, they want to go to Chinatown also. So we're going to go to the Chinatown on Decker's Road, and then after that, we're showing them around Soweto and doing the traditional food experience. I'm really keen for the traditional food, guys. I think it's gonna be really good. I'm not a malamukhori person, so I think I'll try it today just to like confirm. I love to confirm that like I don't like the food, so I think I'll try that just to confirm. But outside of that, that's what you can expect today, and yeah, I'll let you know when we're at China Mall. Bye. We also got like these really cute shots from Woolies. This one's apple ginger lemon. Mom,
we're supposed to get the other one, not apple ginger lemon.
This one is orange turmeric cayenne pepper. Oh, there. Orange turmeric cayenne pepper.
We're supposed to get the... There was another one, not apple ginger.
No. So we decided to get these two because we want to share half and half. These are really great. One's a vitamin C and one is just a ginger shot kick. So these are really great on the road if you feel fluish or just for health, just in general, because it's 2019, babes. Soweto. Yo, guys, did I say Soweto like a white person? Let's say Soweto. We're finally in Soweto. We're just trying to find a place to eat, and China City was so hot, guys. Like, it was so hot. I couldn't even, guys, look at these houses in Soweto. Hey, this is always killing us. This person's put like pot plants and everything. It looks like some house in some estate, but anyways, look at that, perfectly like tended to garden, looking bomb. But anyways, we are trying to find a place to eat. Chinatown was so full, I couldn't even vlog there. It was just really a lot, so I didn't end up doing that. But yeah, I'm really keen to try the food. Ke batla le dombolo, guys. I want dumpling, so I'm really excited for that. And it's so hot here, but also, I didn't realize we'd be giving a history lesson, but yeah, we're actually giving a history lesson also, because you know it's pointless to drive with people and tell them where we are and things, but we're not really explaining what the relevance of this place is. So yeah, and it's actually like, geez, there's so much happening here in terms of restaurants. It's like 4 or 5 new restaurants that I've seen here since the last time I was here. The last time I was here was...
No, I'm fine, thanks.
But why did you take the pictures? I didn't give you permission to take pictures.
It's a hold on
picture. Ah, did you need the papa, please?
Yeah, I mean, how are you taking pictures of me when I've never asked you? But anyways, I think we're coming to Sakumzi. And yeah, it's time to try it on. This stew is so yum. I can't even deal. Like, it's literally the most delicious. It was definitely worth it. I want to try my mom's tripe, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna love it. So I'm really stressed about trying it, but I'm gonna do it. Can I try your tripe? Okay, you're gonna have to film for me. No, ma, bring me your plate. Give me your plate. Okay. Let's see how this goes. That's how it looks. I don't know which piece to have. Come on, move your hands. Ooh, that is how nice. No. It's not a thing. I have to wash the taste out. The smells off, the textures off. It doesn't taste bad, probably the best tasting tripe I've had. But the smell is so off for me and the texture, I can't deal. But yeah, the food here is really good. And the music is good too. It's a bomb. We also get given massages. Keep massaging. Don't be in the video, keep massaging. He's barely doing anything. And we're out. The food was really, really, really great. And we're going home now. No, we're going to Montecasino now. It was raining a little bit, but it's not so much anymore. So now it's just time to get the car. Go to Montecasino just to give them a feel of that. They're going to Santa's tomorrow anyways. And then yeah. I'm so full. We just got to Montecasino and they have this thing called Guess What's in the Box. It's by 94.7. So basically you fill in your details and then you peep in this small little box with like the tiniest slit ever. And then you could win. I don't know what you win, but you know, 94.7 always pulls through. So I really want to try this, I guess. Okay. Let's try Z. Okay. Can't see anything with the camera. So let me try, I guess.
Yeah, why would you put a car like? You never know.
Oh my goodness. What is this?
Have you looked at it? Doesn't it look like, you know, it's beer? You know, it's big. You know, you get those.
So, we think. What do we think it is?
I think it's a beer can. This beer can thing.
One of those big American beer cans.
You know those big jump beer things? What are they called?
Those barrels.
Barrels.
Do you want to be on the vlog?
I think it is.
You think?
That's the one.
Oh, the keg. Yes. The way he's chugging the keg. Okay. You think it's a cell phone? Mm-hmm. Did you look?
I looked. I was just taking a wild guess.
Okay, we really, really think that it is
a car lighter.
You know those little car lighter thingies, the cigarette lighter thing? We think it's one of those. Okay, 94.7, we hope we win. Okay guys, so I'm with Monet and Tristan and we put our guesses in. You guys should come to Montecasino, do it too. And follow them on Monet
_Purple1.
And
Trippy Mouse 18.
Trippy Mouse 18. Okay, guys. You guys think
there
it is?
There's nothing in that box.
You think there's nothing in that box? You think they'd run a whole competition for nothing?
Exactly. Because they know people are like to guess all sorts of things.
Joanne, you really feel there's nothing?
I think there's nothing in that box.
I'm so shocked. They think there's nothing. While Monet, Keegan, and I guessed. We said it's the keg. We said it's the cigarette lighter. Let's hope we're right. Anela, we're watching you. You better call us. Also, comment down below what you think it might be. I guess I could describe it to you guys. Some people are saying it's a cell phone, but I don't see how they could think it's that. It's like this small little silver top. It's like a round silver top. And hence I'm saying it looks like the top of a cigarette lighter. But comment down below if you guys think you know what it is. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Guys, I see you guys viewing these videos, not liking, not subscribing, not commenting. Give it a thumbs up and click that notification bell. He's not interested. Where's my sister when I need her? She was doing that whole notification bell thing in Dubai. But anyways, you guys need to comment, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. What will you say? Say it now.
Subscribe in the button corner right down here.
Subscribe right down here.
And to subscribe to our new channel. And hit the Ali J channel right up there.
Okay. And then you must say bye.
Bye.
I remember being like a teenager, or like, I remember like late high school, I'm late primary school, like grade 7 and grade 8 and grade 9. Everyone, like Montecasino was the chill spot. Everyone from Bryanston Primary, everyone from King School Bryanston, those are schools I went to. This used to be the spot. I have no idea what we did here, but we weren't necessarily even watching a movie or like going for dinner or anything, but this literally used to be the spot. And it's so weird, like, being here and just seeing like all of these kids. It's so weird, and I'm thinking this used to be us. We're so grown, so grown. Anyone born in 96, shout out to you. If you ever came to hang out at Montecasino, shout out to you, and let me know what you came here and did with your squad back in, I think it was like 2009, 2008. I don't know what we did here, guys. Comment down below if you came and let me know the kind of things that you guys used to do. All I remember is running around drinking Monster. That much I remember. So here I was, trying to be a kid again, trying to get a slush puppy. And I got myself into this slush fizz nonsense. And it's really not delicious, guys. It's carbonated fizz slush. And I don't like it. There's something about ice in a slush puppy. This tastes like foam. It's literally like foamy. You can even see like the bubbles. I hate this. I really do. But thank goodness my mom likes this, so we can share it, and hopefully she'll drink more than I do, because I hate this. I've always thought it was weird that Jacaranda literally broadcast right here from Montecasino. I've always thought it was so weird because you can literally see them as they're DJing and everything. For those of you who've never been to Montecasino, I just want to give you a look. I've always thought this whole thing is really weird. You literally get to watch them DJing or being on radio, and it's pretty crazy. So I just wanted to show you guys that.
Jacaranda FM 92.4, is it?
94.2. Got it the other way around. 92.4, guys. 94.2, guys. Do that. I think it's me and radio stations today. It was first YFM. Who are they? 94.7. Now it's 94.2. Jacaranda FM 94.7. What was that? What was 94.7? I actually forgot what 94.7 was. 5FM. Is it? Guys, is it? It is 5FM. Is it? I think it's 5FM. No, it's not. I think it is. I think it is. I'm such a flub, actually. Mind you, I don't listen to any of these radio stations. I only listen to Metro FM.
But yeah, guys, you know, if you stay in Montecasino long enough, you'll literally think it's day. It's so bad. You could be like in the day section and it's like 12 p.m. and you'll literally start thinking that it's daytime. It's bad. Bad, bad, bad. No, but don't like, okay, okay. We went to Montecasino, obviously. So first we went to pick my mom's colleagues up, also a colleague and her mom. They're from Barbados, and I asked her, hey, do you know Rihanna? I was like, that's as good a question as do you keep a lion as a pet? But yeah, so we picked them up from the East Rand, went to Chinatown, then we went to Vilakazi Street, and then showed them like the Mandela house and ate there. And my mom had Tripe, which I showed you guys earlier. And then afterwards we were like, oh, you guys don't know what Montecasino is. So we went and showed them Montecasino, because they're going to Sandton tomorrow, and they'd already done a couple of things. Like they just came back from Cape Town and stuff. So we're just like, okay, let's just show you like one more thing. So yeah, we just got back home, but I wanted to show you guys what I got from Chinatown. First I got like this pea cap. They have these at like Mr. Price and stuff, but I just feel like they're like really pricey, and I like, it's so much easier with my natural hair to run with like a pea cap, and I just wanted like a plain one. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but those of you who follow me on Instagram would have noticed that I run with my Olympus one, which I've had since first year, and yeah, I feel like I've been in Stellenbosch for 4 years now, so I think it was time to just get like a new pea cap. So this is my really cool pea cap. I paid like 35 rand for this one. Also, if you can hear some background noise, it's my parents. They're talking really loudly because we literally just got home. We got home and I closed the door and I was like, I need to finish my vlog. So yeah, I got this, and then I got lashes. So obviously it's the fake China Mall Huda Beauty, but I got these are apparently Huda Beauty eyelashes 033. These look like that. And then I got Red Cherry 827. These are apparently like 100% human hair, so I got those as well. Yeah, so I'm really keen to try these. I felt the Huda ones, but I didn't actually feel, well, the Huda ones, but I didn't really feel these Red Cherry. I just thought they looked really nice. Oh, they also feel good. They feel really good, and they're pretty wispy, so yeah, I'm keen. I've never worn lashes this long. I'm also really struggling in terms of lashes at the moment. Like, I can't really put them on with my long nails. So I haven't been wearing lashes, and I'm gonna try once I take the nails off, and they're due to come off pretty soon because I've got a lot of like growth. Nail growth. And then, oh, I got these. Guys, you won't believe the price on these. 10 rand each. Literally, wait, where are the other ones? 10 rand, 10 rand. I've really been hearing of people, especially like on YouTube, buying lashes for really cheap. And I just feel like, why am I spending like 60 rand, 80 rand on like Allure lashes at Clicks? I don't know if these are like reusable, but it don't matter. Because at least I'll look bomb for like two different occasions. And I usually wear lashes for occasions. So yeah, I'll just use my like reusable ones for like regular. Yeah, so that's two lashes. It cost me 20 rand. Then I got like a Kylie blender. I do have blenders. Guys, I don't know if you remember, but I did say I was new in the makeup scene and things. So I don't know how well this blender is going to work. But I was just really keen for the price, guys. It was literally 15 rand. And I feel like blenders are like 60, 90 rand at Clicks. So I felt like this was a really good buy. I have blenders, but like, you know, those like flat sponge ones. And I just don't feel like they work as well as like the circular one. I got the sponge ones at Dis-Chem for like, how much were those? I think they were, it was a pack of about six, and I think they're like 30 bucks. So this was really a really good investment as well. And I just hope it like works well and like the product doesn't stick or anything like that. So I'm really keen for my lashes and my blender. I'm going to church tomorrow. So today's Saturday, by the way. Don't know if I mentioned that. So I'm really keen to like, maybe I'll do a young face beat. I probably won't because I never have time for that. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys things that I bought. So overall, I spent like 35 rand on the lashes and the blender. And then I spent another 35 rand on my peak cap. So this is literally 70 rand. My math is on fleek. This is 70 rand and I'm really happy with my buys. So yeah, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this vlog. Please give it a like. Leave a comment down below. Tell me if you enjoyed my content. If there's anything in particular that you'd like to see since we're getting up to know each other. Would you guys want like a Q&A or anything else that you'd like to see me film? And don't forget to subscribe, guys. You guys are viewing, but not subscribing. By now, my videos average on 100 views. So I should have at least 100 subscribers. So guys, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And also don't forget to click that notification bell to be the first to get notified when I post a video. Bye guys, I love you so much and I can't wait to see you in the next video.